This video, we shall study about this second unit, that is derived constructical units. So in this video, we will study that what is constructor and what is the scope of variables and what are the visibility controls and all this. See here. Unit 2, derived syntactical constructor in Java. What are the unit outcomes? Use of constructors, scope of variables in Java programs, and visibility controls in Java, array implementation in Java. The total weightage of this chapter is 18 marks. What do you mean by the constructor? A constructor in Java is a special method that is used to initialize the object. The constructor is called when an object of the class is created. It can be used to set the initial values for the object attributes. So we'll see that here. Constructor, that means where the class name is same as that of the method name. So class name kya hai idhar? Bike 1 hai. So we are created a method having the same name as the class name. So that is what the constructor, this is called as a constructor. And this constructor is called the default constructor without the parameters. And in this constructor, we have printed the one statement, that is bike is created, and main method, we are creating the object of the class. And when the object of the class is created, when called, that time only this constructor is called. Is it clear? So creation of the, when the object is initialized, that time only the constructor is called. And then constructor parameters. The constructor can also take the parameter which is used as a initialize the attributes. So here the parameter, the constructor with a parameter is called the parameterized constructor. In second example mein dekho, class ka naam kya hai? Student 4. Iske andar int id hai, int data type, and name is data type of string. And student 4, we have created the class, and in this class is having two parameters, that is int and string n. So this string constructor variables are called as the local variables. We are assigning into the global or instance variables. And in this method, display method, we are created. In this method, we are calling this id and name, global values. And in this main method, we are created the object, two object, that is S1 and S2. That time only we are passing. Student 4 is having two parameters, two parameters we are passing here. And for displaying, we are calling this, using this object of that class, we are calling the display method. The output is like this. So it is what? Parameterized constructor. The constructor with the parameters is called parameterized constructor. And next one is nesting of method. When a method in Java calls the another method in the same class, it is called nesting of method. That means what? In the class, when method is calling the another method, a nesting of method, a class hai, iske andar perimeter ek method hai. And next we are having one more method, this area method. In this area method, we are calling this perimeter method. And in the same class, we are having one more method, that is a volume. In this volume, we are calling this area method. So that is called nesting of method. Java class calls the another method in the same class. It is called nesting of method. And one more thing, here we are using the scanner class. This scanner class is used when user wants to take the input through the user. When the program wants to take the input through the user, that time you are using the scanner class. The scanner is present in UTL package, and UTL package is present in Java. So in C and C++, you are using this import stage or header files. Here same thing, you are using this import. Import means you are to calling this scanner class. So I will run the program and show the output here. See here. So scanner class. So run. So here you are entering. That's for you are using this scanner class. So length, breadth, and height. You are taking the values to the user. For that, you are using scanner class. So here you have printed only this volume that will be inbuilt automatically call this. Here see that volume only you have called. In this volume method only you are area call. Area के अंदर आपने perimeter है. Perimeter तीनों method को अब print हो रहे. I think it is clear. And next conclusion, that is important notes on Java constructors. The constructors are invoked implicitly when you instance objects. When you are instantiate the object, that time only it will constructors are called. The two rules for creating the constructors are, the name of the constructor should be same as that of the class. A Java constructor must not have any return type. Already we have created the constructors. There is no return type. If a class does not have a constructor, Java compiler automatically creates the default constructors during the runtime. The default constructor initializes the instance variables with the default values. For example, int variable will be initialized to zero value. Default values rehta wo constructor initialize karega. If you are not mentioning default constructor ke andar values nahi rahega to. No argument constructor. A constructor does not accept any arguments. Parameterized constructor. Constructor accept the arguments. Default constructor, a constructor that automatically created by the Java compiler if it is not explicitly defined. A constructor cannot be abstract, static or final. Constructor can be overloaded but cannot be overridden. And this reference here in Java ke andar ek this keyword hai. So this keyword kabhi use karte hai. This is a reference variable that refers to the current class instance variable. See that. Carefully listen to this example, then you will come to know why you are using this. So here class test is there. In this class test, we are using two variables. What is the data type of these two variables? Int and variable name is A and B. And here constructor is there. In this constructor also, we are using same data types, int only, and the variables are also same. Data type is also same and variable names are also same. So for that, in this situation we are using this keyword, so that refer to the current class instance variables. Which are the instance variables? These are called as the instance variables. So this dot a means that will refers to this instance variable. Is it clear? This dot a means this a, and this a means there is a constructor variable, and for this case we are using the this keyword, and display we are printing this a. That means we are printing a and b of this. So 10, 10 we are passing here. These are the 10, 10 that will be assigned to the instance variables. I think it is clear. And next, command line arguments in Java with example. Command line arguments in Java is the information that is passed to the program when it is executed. The information passed to stored in the string array passed to the main method, and it is stored as a string. It is the information that is directly follows the program's name on the command line when it is running. So here command line arguments means what? Here simple program is there, class demo, main method is there. So here printed two statements are there, that is a system.out.println, argument 1 and argument 2. That is, we are command line arguments. I will show the example. What is the name of the program? That is Java C demo. Demo.java. So Java demo. So don't press enter key. Just you write the names. Whatever the names you can type here. Here Ram space Sham. So when you are writing the values in front of this interpreter, that is while executing the program, that is called what? Command line arguments. Here argument 1 is Ram and this one is Sham. So while running the program, you are passing the values at the command prompt. It is called command line argument. Is it clear? So here argument 1 b comma b at the b of 0 means here string b of 0 means it takes the whatever value you are passing, Ram and Shyam. Is it clear? Save and compile the code. Run the code java.demo with the values. Is it clear? That is called command line argument. And next is Java garbage collector. Garbage collection in Java is process by which the programs perform memory management automatically. The garbage collector finds the unused object and deletes them to reclaim the memory. Is it clear? So that will performs the memory management automatically. Who will performs? JVM, Java Virtual Machine, will performs the automatic memory management. Dynamic memory allocation object is achieved to be using new operator that uses some memory, and that memory remains allocated until there are reference for the use of the object. That means simple, I will show you with a diagram. So when you are creating the object, that is student S1 equal new student. So this is a what reference variable. When you are S1 equals null means when you are assigning to the null, that means you are removing this reference variable. So this memory will be, this dynamic memory location means when you are using the new operator, that will create the memory of this S1 reference object. So when this reference is assigned to be a null, at that time this memory will not be used because this reference will be assigned as a null. ये time पे ये क्या होया? Garbage value करके ये memory ऐसे ही रह जाते हैं. It is a, when you are using new operator use करके जो create करता है वो memory dynamic memory बोलते हैं. You cannot delete this memory. So memory के अंदर ये तो मैं ऐसे ही diagrammatically दिखाया. Memory के अंदर free रहते हैं. Memory कभी use करते हैं उसको बोलते हैं consumed. So जब भी न्यू ऑपरेटर यूज करते हैं वो कंज्यूम हो जाते हैं. तो ये जो इसको नल करेगा तो ये मेमोरी का स्पेस जो है उसको रिमूव करने के लिए सो हम ऑटोमेटिकली जेवीएम यूज करते हैं. जेवीएम क्या करता है, ऐसा वाला मेमोरी को वो डिलीट करता है. सो इसको बोलते हैं गार्बेज कलेक्टर. जैसा म्यूनिसिपैलिटी का गाड़ी आके जो यूज नहीं रहते उसको सब हटाते हैं, वैसे ही सेम इधर JVM क्या करेगा, एक मेथड यूज करके, फाइनलाइज मेथड यूज करके उसको स्पेस कॉन्यूज मेथड स्पेस को रिमूव करता है व्हेन रेफरेंस वेरिएबल नहीं रहेगा. तो फाइनलाइज मेथड इज इनवोक्ड ईच टाइम बिफोर द ऑब्जेक्ट इज गार्बेज कलेक्टेड. दिस मेथड कैन बी यूज टू परफॉर्म क्लीनअप पर्पस के लिए, प्रोसेसिंग के लिए. And garbage collector of JVM collects only those objects that are created by new keyword. न्यू कीवर्ड से जो ऑब्जेक्ट क्रिएट हुआ रहता है उसी को ही वो डिलीट करता है. सो इफ यू हैव क्रिएटेड एनी ऑब्जेक्ट विद विदाउट न्यू, यू कैन यूज द फाइनलाइज मेथड टू परफॉर्म द क्लीन अप प्रोसेसिंग, डिस्ट्रॉइंग द रिमेनिंग ऑब्जेक्ट. सो एंड दिस फाइनलाइज मेथड कैसे था, यूज ऑफ फाइनलाइज समटाइम ऑब्जेक्ट विल नीड टू बी परफॉर्म सम एक्शन व्हेन इट इज डिस्ट्रॉयड. If an object holding some non-Java resources such as file handle or window character font, and therefore object is garbage collected and these resources should be freed. How to use this finalize method? See, this finalize method you are calling that. That time it will release the, it will clean up the memory management. Is it clear? And next, variable arguments. The where args allows the method to accept the zero or multiple arguments before where args. Either you can use the overloaded method or take an array of method parameter, but it not be considered as a good seer. इसका मैं बता दूँ, time shortage का होगा, मैं पढ़ रहा नहीं, आप लोग पढ़ो इसको. Seer, when the arguments are not fixed, that time you are using. So what is where args uses this? Three dots after the data types. First, you have to mention the data type and three dots and the variable name. Here, display method है, display method के अंदर data type कौन सा है? String है and three dots and the values you are mentioning. Here, display three values and varax इसके. So there are four arguments. When the ये भी आपका argument ही है. When the arguments are not fixed, that time you are using this varax variable. Is it clear? Display method is invoked. Display method is invoked. Output is calling. So that will finish this first video.